number three ranked Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Hi, everyone. I'm Matt Devlin along with Doris Burke. We're certainly glad to have you along. This game features two of the finest point guards in the country. Notre Dame's Muffet McGraw thinks that she has the best in the L. Ivory. A lot of people think that it's UConn Sue Bird.
The fact of the matter is that in their respective systems, these two players carry out their roles to near perfection. For the Fighting Irish, it's Neil Ivy, the senior leader, the poised veteran, the player who can get them in their up-tempo game, and when necessary, score the basketball. She averages over 7 assists a game. When you think about the Connecticut Huskies, you think about their veteran point guard, Sue Bird. Her mentality is, if you leave me open, I'm going to shoot it. But her preference and the thing she likes to do best is find the vast array of talent that surrounds her. The numbers bear this out, Matt. Sue Bird averaging under double figures. For Neil Ivy, she must score for her team to have a chance to win.
There's no question about that. Well, on Saturday, Ruth Riley injured her right ankle against Virginia Tech. Can she continue to be a dominant force? We'll find out next.
The WWF Fanatic Series, featuring WWF World Television premieres. This month, Divas, Postcards from the Caribbean. See the women of the WWF as you've never seen them before. Mick Foley hosts this pay-per-view edition that goes behind the scenes with the ladies to find out what they do with their time in and out of the ring. The Divas send you a postcard you won't soon forget. The WWF Fanatic Series, bringing you WWF World Television premieres. Divas, Postcards from the Caribbean is in demand all month long on pay-per-view.
Not what I had in mind.
30 superstars, one ring. The WWF Royal Rumble is in demand live Sunday, January 21st.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, when you call us, we don't just pick up the phone. We pick you up.
Car right here.
This is great.
Thank you.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
You are a lioness. Very sexy, very sensual. Make love to the camera. Yes!
Want a better way to save money?
New camera, please.
You can save big bucks by dialing 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
Some people you could always count on to be there for you. We were there when you fixed up your first car. And when you fixed up your first apartment. We were even there when you finally got fixed up yourself. So now that you're fixing more bottles than old cars, there's no one better to talk to about your changing life insurance needs than the State Farm agent you've always trusted to care for your car, your home, and you. State Farm is there for you because State Farm is there for life.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Call 1-800-RENT-A-CAR. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Welcome back to the Joy Center in South Bend, Indiana. The Notre Dame Fighting Irish have won 31 in a row here at home. Let's check out the starting lineup. First for the UConn Huskies, Sue Bird, Shea Rouse, Svetlana Abrosimova, Kelly Schumacher, and how about Wing Ken?
Well, she relied early in her career on instincts and athleticism. She has added a jump shot and an ability to use the dribble, and it's become a little more creative offensively. Gino says, the most consistent player I've had all year.
Gino Auriemma in his 16th season. He has been outstanding against Notre Dame and a lot of other teams as well. Five consecutive 30-plus win seasons for Gino Auriemma. For Notre Dame, they're starting five. Ritai Ivy, Kelly Seaman, and she broke her left hand on Saturday. She will play Haney, and then, of course, Ruth Riley.
The best center in women's college basketball. She has not played well during the course of her career against Connecticut. She must stay on the floor out of foul trouble, and we'll see whether her ankle can keep up with the pace of the game.
Muffet McGraw, an outstanding job in her 14th season at the helm of the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. She is 3-0 this season against top 10 opponents, but she has never beaten UConn. Kelly Seaman, she injured her left hand, in fact, broke it on Saturday against Virginia Tech. She saw a specialist this morning. The specialist said, hey, listen, No more damage. Go out, play with it. We'll re-examine it tomorrow.
Now she'll shoot free throws righty, but when she gets close, it's a left-handed basket.
Off the tip. Riley comes down with the board. Lead pass, Seaman able to track it down. Haney.
And here's where you've got to be careful if you're Notre Dame. You must stop transition buckets. They can't score easily.
Ivy takes it away. Approach them over, trying to get back.
And here's the mentality issue. The bottom line is when you step between the lines against Connecticut, you've got to believe in your heart that you can compete. And the Notre Dame staff vows that this is a more mature, confident Notre Dame team. We shall see.
Muffet McGraw jokingly said, hey, listen, I may play my starters all 40 minutes.
Well, that's the mentality that each team has to have. You have to play through fatigue and take your standing eights against Connecticut.
Here's swing pass, draws contact. No.
I think they get it with sticks before, but defensively, Notre Dame has proven itself to be one of the best in the country. Ivy gets the strip. She's got great hands. And despite the fact that two are coming to challenge her, she's able to finish. Good concentration.
So two consecutive turnovers, and Notre Dame has possession of the basketball. Riley. Trying to establish her down low.
We've got an outstanding matchup down there. 6'5", Schumacher for Connecticut and Riley. Different physiques, with different approaches to the game, but an excellent matchup.
Abrosimova. Just like that to three.
Well, she's been struggling shooting the basketball, so for Connecticut, you're thrilled, and now they come with a little 2-2-1, soft pressure.
Met over the last two games, 4-17 from the floor. But she has done other things. Seaman outside, Haney. Ivy in the middle, and Schumacher takes it away.
It is. The number one thing on the mind of the Notre Dame staff is turnovers. Let's keep that number down.
Abrosimova. And last touch by UConn. It's Notre Dame's basketball, and thus far that zone working early.
Well, 2-3 zone. When you have limited depth, you protect your players in a zone. They trap along the baseline drive. It ends up going off Svetlana. Okay, that's exactly what they're looking for right there. Connecticut, they're going to challenge their jump shooting ability right now, Notre Dame. Can they stick it?
Great look by Ivy.
And I'll tell you what, everybody watching senses the same thing we do. This is a confident Notre Dame team right now.
And that's what they talked about all week long. Spoke to Muffet McGraw, spoke to Neil Ivy. All of them talked about their confidence this year.
You see why Muffet says she's the best point guard in the country. She finds people, and she knows how to make pinpoint passes. Here's a player who has overcome some serious injuries during the course of her career.
Schumacher picks up the foul. Seaman, not a good free throw shooter, but is able to get it back. We're tied in a hurry. Better than 60% from beyond the arc. Ralph cut off. And another turnover. How many times this early in the game do you see UConn turning the ball over like this?
Rarely. It's been years since I've seen him collapse this hard in a game early on. You see the baseline drive by Shea Ralph. He does this extremely well. And she's actually out of bounds. She doesn't travel with it. She's on the end line.
Here's Ivy. You see the turnovers early. Haney coming off of 17 against Virginia Tech. Muffet McGraw felt that early on the key was just to sustain UConn, but they're doing more than that.
Well, you see, Connecticut's going to get up into you, so you've got to have the attitude, I'm going to go around, and that's when help comes up, and you've got to find people once you do get by that initial pressure.
Riley has not been limited by that ankle, has 4 points. The dump down low. Ball reversal. In transition, Ivy. Haney doesn't go.
Yeah, she's got a couple good looks, and she hasn't knocked them down.
That's where she excels. In transition, an air ball by Sue Bird, and she'll hear it from the sold-out crowd here at the Joyce Center.
Well, one of the things you think about when you think about Buffett is the fact that she's always had the mentality, I'm going to outscore you. And that's changed this year. She said, I've learned my lesson. You think about Georgia and Tennessee, teams that get up into you and have the mentality, you're not going to score on us. She knows that Notre Dame's got to come with that as well.
Take a look early on. UConn just 1 of 5. Notre Dame, 50%. Remember, the Irish have played together for a long time. Experience certainly on their side.
Well, their coach was business as usual. They didn't point to this game as much as they have in past seasons, saying, hey, here's one we have to have.
Loose ball on the floor. Asia Jones comes away with it. Taurasi, the freshman, on the pull-up. Too strong. Another opportunity for Notre Dame.
Well, that wasn't a bad look, but they have quick shot the basketball.
How about that move?
Yeah. Nice and poised. And Ruth doing a nice job getting up and down the floor.
3 of 3 from the floor. 6 points and a pair of boards. Svet from outside. Great dish.
Yeah, that's tough. Because Svet is not shooting the basketball well, but you've got to block out. So often you forget about shooting.
Williams now working over on Rattai.
All man to man thus far by Connecticut. And Rattai, outside of that one quick look, hasn't shot the ball.
Timeout on the floor. 14:58 remaining here on the campus of the University of Notre Dame. And they're loving it early on here at the Joy Center. It's a sold out crowd. And the Irish are up.
NBA Tonight, Tuesday through Saturday, late night on ESPN2.
Call Roto-Rooter, that's the name, and away go troubles down the drain. Roto-Rooter.
Speed, reliability, performance. The qualities that won Lance Armstrong the Tour de France. Now, they're available in international delivery. Introducing Global Express Guaranteed from the U.S. Postal Service and DHL. Delivery to over 200 countries in as little as 2 days guaranteed. Now, you'll know which team to ride with.
Fly like an eagle.
Your gray beard or mustache reflect on you.
Man, I look old.
Get new vitamin-enriched Just for Men gel, the Rejuvenator, specially made to penetrate coarse gray in 5 minutes and match your hair. The Rejuvenator Just for Men gel.
Notre Dame by 5 early on against the number one ranked UConn Huskies. And Doris, 8 of the 10 points have come from the inside.
Well, Connecticut will get up and pressure you. So Rattai does the wise thing. She goes back door and then she finds Ruth stepping two. And then Ruth just filling the lane here after a rebound on the other end. Nice patience inside. She's got the size to score over people against Connecticut. You look at her effectiveness, 64% from the floor of Brosimova and Cash. We've got some shooters on the floor today, no question.
And Riley has not had great success in the past against the UConn Huskies. Shot clock violation. UConn.
Well, it's foul trouble, and it's been recent. You know, she's had limited minutes against Connecticut because she's gotten herself into early foul trouble.
Another air ball by the Huskies. 1 of 5 from 3 now. Taurasi threw up an air ball. Bird threw up an air ball, and Svetlana Abrosimova, 1 of 3 from the floor. Haney dumps it down low.
You gotta wonder if Kelly can catch the basketball.
How about Ivy from outside?
Yeah, you see, Connecticut is interested in giving some assistance on Riley. You know, the opposite post player is thinking about her, so it's up to Seaman or somebody else to step in the gap and become effective scorer.
Ivy, another turnover, second in the nation from beyond the arc at 53%. a concern look on the face of Gino.
Yes, well, it should be. I mean, this is an uncharacteristic situation for his team. They are one of the most effective, but Ivy, tell you what, she can flat out shoot the basketball. They don't get out and cover her in time, and she will let you know it. She's a player who must score for her team to win.
Has to handle the pressure as well as she brings it up. Haney has missed a couple early.
That's the tag. Ruth's already going to pick up a foul on that, but she realized she was beat. She understands she needs to be on the floor, so she pulls back. Smart.
Riley. Great feed to Seaman. Count it and one.
There's exactly what I'm talking about. Riley, because of her presence, 6'5". Here's a kid who can score, but she doesn't have to take a lot of shots to become effective. She's an outstanding passer because she's faced double and triple teams her entire career. But back to the basket, she's going to feel the defense here, and Seaman, whoever is playing that opposite post, must fill the lane and make themselves available. Nice job by Seaman to catch this. There's a double, there's a step two, boom. Excellent execution.
Off the glass, and it works. Muffin McGraw has said that it is Kelly Seaman who really has been one of the most valuable players for her team because there's so much focus on Riley and Ivy.
Well, she's unheralded. She rebounds the ball. She knocks down 15-foot jump shots when you leave her open. All the little things.
Started her first two seasons, came off the bench last year, and this year back in the lineup.
It'd be interesting to see how Sue Bird approaches this game, because this season, with the vast array of talent, she shoots it only when necessary. From here, sensing her team needs a bucket, she sticks it.
Talked to Gino before the game, and he said that she must take shots.
Yes. You have to be a legitimate scoring threat, or people are going to back off you and make other people around you harder to score.
From the outside, that one rolls out. Rekhi sneaks in on the weak side. The freshman, Jenica Joyce from Topeka, Kansas, on the floor for the Irish.
She has seen limited production because of injuries, but an athlete is somebody who gives him quickness.
Notre Dame gets it back. 12 on the shot clock. Under 10 now. Riley calling for it. Played only 5 minutes against St. John's. Did not play against Virginia Tech. Has been slowed because of a stress fracture. 7-16 now from three-point range. And a whistle and a foul.
This is a team that leads the country in three-point percentage, and there are more than one option for Muffet McGraw to go to.
Ivy picks up her first. Muffet has to be satisfied that Riley, 8 minutes in, does not have a foul.
No, there's no question. What she told Ruth this season, Matt, was, Ruth, we don't want to see a single foul on the offensive end of the floor. And on the defensive side, the only foul you can get is on blocked shots. Therefore, for minutes production goes up, they're off to their best start in history, 16-0.
She said early on in the season, she said, if you pick one up in the first 5 minutes, I'm sitting you.
Yeah.
She said that lasted for about one game. Nine-point advantage for Notre Dame. Kenita Johnson in. There she is on the wing.
Now this morning, against a 2-3 zone, Connecticut worked hard on hitting the short corner.
Asia Jones has that in her repertoire.
Asia Jones is flat out one of the most talented juniors in the country. She doesn't always show it, but she's got a vast array of weapons.
Coaching staff thinks she's underrated. Entry pass. Riley racking him up. Has 8 points. Whistle and a foul.
Fouls on the Irish number 50.
Seaman picks up the foul. That's her first. Timeout on the floor with 11:22 remaining here in South Bend, Indiana. Notre Dame early on getting work from the inside and also racking it up from the outside.
Women's Basketball, the premier magazine for this dynamic and fast-growing sport, featuring the stars of the court, from the WNBA to the college game to the high school scene. Women's Basketball magazine takes you from front row action to behind the scenes. Get with the game with a subscription to Women's Basketball. Call 1-800-561-2065 to receive 8 issues for just $19. That's over 50% off the newsstand price. Call 1-800-561-2065 to stay on top of the world of women's basketball.
Daddy, can I have some cheese?
Sure, honey.
This is my friend Mr. Giggles. He wants a piece too.
Mr. Giggles, huh?
Yeah, he really wants some.
Well, Mr. Giggles, why don't you go get a job so you can buy your own cheese?
Oh, I see you met Mr. Giggles.
Ah, the power of cheese.
When you have an ailment, different doctors might recommend different treatments. But for women suffering with yeast infections, the number one recommendation of doctors is specific. Monistat. Monistat starts working immediately to relieve the awful burning and itching, and it provides an effective cure. Sure, doctors have many brands of yeast infection medicine to choose from, but Monistat is their number one choice. Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand.
ND leads 21-12 over the number one-ranked UConn Huskies. Three great games are featured tomorrow night on ESPN and ESPN2 at 7 o'clock. The fast-rising number 16th-ranked Iowa Hawkeyes meet the number 18th-ranked Wisconsin Badgers. The Badgers almost upset third-ranked Michigan State this past weekend. Then at 9 o'clock, number 4 Tennessee meets Kentucky in a border battle. That game kicks off at 9 o'clock. At 7:30 p.m. on ESPN2, the Boston College Eagles, they travel to Durham to meet the number 2-ranked Duke Blue Devils. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.
Two blocks there. Chain shot, a block by Ruth Riley.
Steeman, how about that? Takes it away from the Brostomova.
Well, the thing you're concerned about coming in with Steeman is, could she go after the basketball and grasp it? It's the fourth metatarsal on the left hand, but she seems to be able to grasp it and turn it.
And also pass out of it. Rattan turns it over. Lead pass, win catch. Takes it right to Steeman. And last touch by Notre Dame, and Steeman gets up slowly.
Now, there was some contact. Sally Bell, the baseline official, though contact was made, if you can't see it, it's better not to blow the whistle. And that's the philosophy of most officials. Bucket, of course, 97, the final four. Returning break here with Beth Morgan and Katrina Gaylor, now established as a legitimate top 10. Here is her Goliath. Can she get Connecticut?
Haney checks in. Notre Dame has been superb from the floor. The belief in them is a little bit stronger this year than in years past.
Well, I think you can sense it. There is a different level of confidence about them.
A place to Mulgrew. Doesn't go. Riley, another bully. Here's Haney.
You can tell she's jittery now. The least experience to the players on the floor.
Riley, great look. Enjoy. Comes away with the bucket. She's got five.
That's Riley's second assist, and it's a five. She has done an outstanding job thus far of feeling defenders and finding people.
The lead grows, 23-12. Halfway through here in the first half.
This is where Connecticut can get you. They rebound from almost every position.
The dump down low. The reverse by Jones, and she shows you outside and inside.
Yeah, you say she's one of the more talented in her class. She's got the jump shot from 15. She's stepped out now, increased that range, but she also around the bucket, tough to guard.
Averaging close to 10 in 19 and a half minutes. The laner pops in and out.
Normally, you'll see Muffa change defenses a little bit more. I said, how about some jump like she always does? She said, nope, but two balls.
Jones, they go back to her on the inside. She was a little bit concerned about man-to-man, especially with Kelly Schumacher. And she said after Kelly gets off the floor, we'll sit back in that zone a little bit.
Well, they'll pick their spots to play man, but the 2-3 has been so effective. And what's questioning right now for Connecticut, they're trying to be effective along their front line. Only Asia Jones has done so, and now they come with Kelly Schumacher.
Replaces Jones, who just picked up her first. Schumacher enters. She has one. Haney has him connected from underneath.
That's a force right there, really. A shot that's unnecessary because you have some time on the clock to work with.
0-5 from the floor. And throws him over from the corner. That's a tough shot.
It's no question, but she did a nice job of finding seams. She had the pass. She got rid of it. She relocates, and that's not easy.
Timeout taken by Notre Dame as Svetlana Obrosimova connects on her second three, and right now it's a four-point game.
Hi, I'm Mike McCray, number 99 of the Ravens. For Baltimore's other superstar, Musselman's Dodge.
Musselman's Dodge Used Car Superstore has the finest selection of used cars anywhere, including caravans, SUVs, and 4x4s, and all at super low prices.
Now that's a winning deal.
Plus, all come with a minimum 3-month, 3,000-mile service contract, personalized service, and helpful financing.
I ask you again, how can you lose? You can't.
Musselman's Dodge Used Car Superstore, Route 40 West, just off Beltway Exit 15A.
The superstar of used cars.
Jordan's greatness.
He doesn't hold anything back.
We got a brouhaha here.
Phil Jackson was never the coach of that team. Jordan was the one they feared.
Everybody made money through Michael Jordan.
I think he remains angry that the gambling is what people tried to bring him down on.
Michael Jordan, Sports Century, the top 50 and beyond. Tonight at 8 Eastern, 9 Pacific, only on ESPN Classic. You can only see Sports Century by calling 1-800-CLASSIC today.
UConn on a run, and right now it's a four-point game.
One of their strengths, Connecticut, is ball movement. You've got to find people. The collapse by Ratai, Svetlana stays spread in the corner. It gives her a wide-open three. She's got 6 points, six boards. And when you look at the game summary, Matt, you're talking about Notre Dame's ability to shoot the ball effectively.
UConn, 8-22. Take a look at the points in the paint. 14 for Notre Dame. They've pounded it inside. And right now, the Huskies on a 7-0 run, and Muffin was brought out of the timeout, goes to the corner, Joyce misses the three. Last touch by Notre Dame, UConn ball.
Oh, good solid checkout on the weak side by Kelly Schumacher on Riley. Seems going to be important for Muffin, but I think she's got to have solid minutes. She's been there before, she's experienced.
Sue Bird, and prior to that, a whistle.
They had to play La Tech in Ruston and then Syracuse, and all prognosticators had this team in a slump. They didn't come out strong turning the ball over here.
Ivy picked up her second, and the bucket down low. Schumacher.
Yeah, Shuey's stock went way up in the championship game of last year's against Tennessee. 11 blocks for her.
And a turnover. It's a two-point game. And a 9-0 run put together by the UConn Huskies. And Notre Dame holding on tightly with 5:57 remaining here in the first half. We'll be back right after this.
32, 33, 34, 45, 46, 47, 50, 51, 52.
Cold symptoms keeping you awake?
What?
Get NyQuil. The nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever so you can get the sleep you need to feel better medicine.
Little body foo foo.
Before you choose a security company, consider this. Only
ADT protects your home and family with three solid guarantees, plus a special fire safety offer. It's the ADT Fire Protection Package. If you move, we'll install a system in your new home free of charge. If you're not happy with your system, ADT will refund the installation cost and monitoring fees. We'll even save you up to 20% on your basic homeowner's insurance. Call now and get an ADT security system installed from $99. And for a limited time, we'll also include a free ADT fire extinguisher. This invaluable home safety device is manufactured by Ansel, the fire safety leader. So get the peace of mind of the ADT Fire Protection Package. Get the power of ADT.
The Irish by two. Hey, there's more great women's basketball next Sunday on ESPN2 with a Big 12 ACC Challenge. The action starts at 1 o'clock Eastern when the number 7th-ranked Iowa State Cyclones play the number 18th-ranked North Carolina State Wolfpack. Then at 3 o'clock, number 16th-ranked Oklahoma meets the North Carolina Tar Heels. See both of these great games next Sunday on ESPN2. ESPN and ESPN2, the exclusive home of the women's NCAA basketball tournament. It has been a long time, Doris, since they last lost here at the Joyce Center.
It was 31 games ago, and to who else but Connecticut back in 1998.
In fact, in Big East competition here at home, they are 44-3 all time, and guess who those three losses are against? The UConn Huskies. Riley gets a piece of it.
Well, they're playing solid defense. She does a nice job in that zone, Riley, of picking her spots to lose contact and go ahead and try to make the steal.
Here's Haney. The double comes, spins baseline. Bound. Seaman misses. With the left hand to spot the fact that it's broken.
Now, you like their mentality in there. They're just attacking the bodies of Connecticut. Ruth Riley not afraid to use the dribble. That's something we've not seen her do along the baseline. Wow.
7 points for Seaman. Schumacher steps outside. Cash hustles and saves it.
That's Bird. Always have an eye open to where people are on the floor.
UConn basketball, this is certainly a concern. How do you handle that pressure? You need more than just Neil Ivey handling the basketball.
Well, the thing you think about against pressure is Muffet reacts to it. She's telling Alicia, hey, find the right people against pressure. Be composed. Don't turn and make a quick pass without seeing where defenders are. And that's what she did. Make the easy pass. Go behind you if you have to.
2-point game. Jones was active earlier, inside and outside.
And as you said, they go man-to-man selectively. Notre Dame in a man now.
On the drive, Bird misses. We're tied.
Great ball pressure from Taurasi.
Here's Ivy for three.
Wow.
Lighting it up.
Bird, don't turn your back on her. She's too solid a shooter.
2 of 2 from three. They don't take many, around 9 a game, but they're 53% from beyond the arc.
Now they're changing again. Back to the 2-3.
In the corner.
How about those 2 plays by Taurasi?
Bird, the bucket.
Bird fired up. You don't see a react like that very often.
Seaman responds, has 9.
You score on us, we're going to come right back and score on you. They're turning the table here. This is what Connecticut does to teams.
The Irish have been able to respond and react to that 9-0 run. Loose ball on the floor, corralled by Riley.
Let's see, I think it should be a foul, and I believe Salivette does have a foul. That Benita Spence is going to get it.
Swing Cass picks up the foul. That's her first, and Cass will immediately go to the bench, and Tamika Williams comes off of the bench.
Well, a poor outlet pass at the feet of Rattani. It causes a scramble, but you love her scrap. Ruth is not afraid. She's got a long way down to go from 6'5".
Spoke to the head coach of the Georgia Lady Dogs this morning, Andy Landers, and he said the big thing, the versatility of the UConn Huskies, but he also said he didn't think that the depth would be that big of a factor because he said Notre Dame plays at a different tempo, and if they can control it and play at their tempo, they'll be a factor, and that's what they're doing thus far.
They haven't been afraid to run and shoot quick shots. You see Seaman score, and here's a quick look for Ruth in transition. They're going to have to get their break in the timeout situations, and Muffin will use those wisely. But here's a mentality that you've got to come with. If a team like Connecticut is not getting back and you can get out and get some easy shots, do so. Ruth Riley, excellent job getting up the floor. I was wondering, can this kid keep up with the pace of the Connecticut game? And guess what? Today she has.
Despite that sprained ankle she suffered this past Saturday against Virginia Tech with 14 minutes left in the game.
You see her numbers during the course of her career. First in blocks, first in field goal percentage overall, second in free throws attempted. I mean, she is all over their books.
Two-time All Big East Defensive Player of the Year. Seven-point game. Second chance opportunity.
Yeah, you see, rebounding comes from five positions for Connecticut. You've got to check everybody out.
Turnover. Notre Dame basketball. Seven-point game. Riley, tied up, possession arrow in favor of Notre Dame.
Yes, Muffin McGraw, why are you so much better defensively than you were a year ago? She said, I'm better athletically, my kids are a year older, they're understanding the concepts more, and they're committed to it.
Weak side, a blows them over. Comes down awkwardly, and ahead, Ralph lays it up and in.
This is one of the rare mistakes we've seen by Notre Dame. They haven't given up many easy transition buckets. When you ask why Leon Barmore was so successful, he got back. He sold out and made sure he wasn't beaten the full court game.
And that was their first transition basket, in fact. Joyce on the inside. Rattan from the outside. Knocks it down. Rattan 31% from three-point range. Number one in the nation.
You shave her. I don't care where you are, but you shade her.
The Irish 4-6 from three-point range. And you know it's coming from two locations, Ivy and Rattan. Shot clock under 10. Ralph puts it on the floor. Great D. The help came from Rattan and Riley. With 3:17 remaining in the first half, Notre Dame leads 35-27. It's sold out here at the Joyce Center, and they're loving it early on. And we're back with more in a moment.
Before you choose a security company, consider this. Only ADT protects your home and family with three solid guarantees, plus a special fire safety offer. It's the ADT Fire Protection Package. If you move, we'll install a system in your new home free of charge. If you're not happy with your system, ADT will refund the installation cost and monitoring fees. We'll even save you up to 20% on your basic homeowner's insurance. Call now and get an ADT security system installed from $99. And for a limited time, we'll also include a free ADT fire extinguisher. This invaluable home safety device is manufactured by Ansel, the fire safety leader. So get the peace of mind of the ADT Fire Protection Package. Get the power of ADT.
Discover the amazing training secrets of Baseball World's dynamic practice organization video, featuring professional scout and instructor Tommy Mansky and his famous step-by-step building block approach to athletic training. These are the same techniques that have produced Baseball World's back-to-back-to-back AAU National Championship teams. Parents, players, and coaches are amazed at the rapid improvement of students using these principles, enhancing arm strength, running speed, quickness, and agility. Dynamic practice organization works for all ages and levels of ability and is a great gift to order now.
Notre Dame up 35-27, the number one shooting team in the country, shooting just 38% from the floor. The reason why, great D early on. This is what Muffin McGraw had to say about it.
Learned my lesson. We need to play better defense if we're going to succeed. We played the 2-3 zone and got to the Final Four in 97, so we're back using the zone a little bit more. I think we have an attitude now. We don't want people to score. We're trying to hold teams down, get them to shoot poorly, working on our rebounding, and that's been the ticket to our success.
Take a look at those numbers right there. Speaks volumes of what Muffin McGraw's D has been able to accomplish here in the first half.
Well, you think about those programs in the history of the women's basketball tournament, and those who are legitimate top 10 teams year in, year out, Georgia, Tennessee, Connecticut, they flat out make stops. And Notre Dame doing it with a 2-3 zone. Normally the mentality is man-to-man, but you got to go with your personnel. She's got to protect. She's not deep, so you sit in that zone.
Haney puts it on the floor and gets it connect. Gets it back, second chance, and finally she does.
Yeah, that might be a breakthrough for the young woman. She's got great athleticism. Her basketball skills are coming around.
The junior from Toledo, Ohio. Their largest lead. UConn doesn't respond.
Youthful exuberance. You don't mind it because she's being aggressive, and you want her to keep that mentality, so Muffet stays positive. But she's made some questionable decisions. She's missed some shippings. Now it comes a test of character here. Can you stand it and come back?
Bird sends it on the wing to Ralph, quickly on the near side, of course, him over. Stuck in that zone. Jones shoots over top. Doesn't go. Cash. And an offensive foul. How about Ruth Riley?
Here's why I like not being official and get the benefit of the second look. Because you can tell, if you drop the shoulder, and that's primarily when you get it, she does lean in, and therefore Bonita Spence says it goes the other way.
The ninth turnover for UConn. Ivy from the outside. The senior from St. Louis wants to get there for the Final Four. She's doing her part today.
Now, Connecticut has not been put in this position. Will they respond?
Their largest lead. It's 40-27. Coming up on halftime, the Monistat Halftime Report. Sports Center in game. The number two, Lady Vols lose Catchings. And we'll have to wait and see the latest with that. And then, of course, some afternoon hoops. An 8-0 run by Notre Dame. A flurry, and Cash comes away with it.
It's amazing how many times, if you are aggressive and set the tone, the ball bounces your way.
Wow. Gets the roll. You get those. Now 4-10. Last two games, as I mentioned earlier, just 4-17 from the floor, has 11 points.
She's been their only consistent threat from three-point territory. She's 3-6 from out there.
Under a minute remaining in the first half. The Irish by 10. Approach him over. Comes away with the steal. And Haney, the contact. And Abrosimova frustrated because she was unable to finish.
Now, here's a player who, at the start of the year, Judo was saying she has played her best basketball in the history of her career. Her turnover numbers are way down this season, and she has done so much for this program. She's consistently scored. She's consistently rebounded. She makes people around her better. Her weakness, his decision-making and turnovers, and, of course, a little bit of defense as a freshman.
Yeah.
Typical European.
Coming into this game, 57 assists and 17 turnovers.
Yes.
What a dramatic difference.
Well, when you consider that the ball is in furs and shades, they handle it so much, those turnover numbers become more remarkable.
Williams in, along with Taurasi. Take a look at the free throws.
Yeah, Connecticut, the team remarkably efficient at getting easy shots over the foul line. This is only their second attempt.
On the year, 70%.
I'm Bob Stevens. Last year on Martin Luther King Day, Tennessee was handed its worst SEC loss ever. Georgia hammered it by 27. Now, that didn't hurt Pat Summitt as much as today's game with Mississippi State. When coming up on SportsCenter in-game, the Lady Vols left breathless when their biggest star goes down. We'll also have the Knicks, who are 12-2 on MLK Day. Glenn Rice and company trying to stop the Spurs.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Just for Men. More than a hair color, it's the Rejuvenator. Ends gray in 5 minutes. Looks natural.
How does your gray beard or mustache reflect on you?
Man, I look old.
Get new vitamin-enriched Just for Men gel. The Rejuvenator. Specially made to penetrate coarse gray in 5 minutes and match your hair. The Rejuvenator. Just for Men gel.
It's unique. It's effective. It's orange.
New Nicorette Orange.
It's Nicorette.
So I still help prevent cravings on my own regular schedule.
I still help answer cravings with another piece.
And now I have orange.
Brand new orange flavor. Only from Nicorette.
Here, taste this.
Now this just may be a flavor I can quit with.
Sometimes victory's so close.
You can taste it.
You can do it. New Nicorette Orange can help.
You want a piece of me, Grandpa?
Just drive it right down the center.
Right down the center with 1-800-CALL-ATT. Great for collect calls.
But not so great for trash-talking rookies.
Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Say it!
1-800-CALL-ATT.
Good boy.
My family, their smiles are priceless. But their teeth? Now those I can put a price on. Thank goodness for the People's Dental Plan, because now we get great discounts at the dentist. Look, Charlie's checkup, we saved $57. Brittany's braces, we'll save nearly $1,000. Rob's root canal, we saved over $300. And when the queen needed a crown, we saved royally. We even saved on Dad's dentures. The People's Dental Plan keeps this family smiling.
Join the People's Dental Plan.
This discount program covers you and everyone in your household for one low monthly fee and guarantees you savings of 20 to 50% or more on everything from routine checkups and x-rays to root canals, braces, even cosmetic treatments. Just show your card at a participating dentist near you and save. Great dentists, great discounts. The People's Dental Plan.
Call 1-800-272-6100 for free information on the People's Dental Plan. Call now.
If you suffer from any of these health problems, a Craftmatic adjustable bed with built-in massage and soothing heat may provide the temporary relief from pain you've been looking for. Call now and we'll mail you this special free $200 off rebate certificate. It's good for $200 off the Craftmatic Model 1 bed of your choice. Don't suffer needlessly. Get the facts about the affordable adjustable beds that may provide temporary relief.
Call toll-free 1-800-544-1000.
Welcome to SportsCenter In-Game. Time for the Monistat Halftime Report. I'm Bob Stevens in our ESPN studios. Not many women south of Storrs, Connecticut, have looked good, playing mighty Tennessee. But Mississippi State's LaToya Thomas scored 20 and 25 against the Lady Vols last year as a freshman. While UConn and Notre Dame locked in mortal combat today, number three Lady Vols need to take care of SEC business. Hadn't lost at home since 96. Lady Bulldogs up six early. Cynthia Hall's three-point shot is off, grabs her own board and scores. Still first half. Tennessee down four. Tamika Catchings, the All-American, nails the three. Pat Summitt still not very happy. Her team tied at 27 at the half. Scary moment. Under 6 minutes left in the second half. Tennessee up seven. Tamika Catchings on the layup attempt goes down hard, holding her right knee, and it looked like she hurt it going up. She would have to leave the game. 17 points and 13 boards for Catchings. We're still waiting for an update on her condition. Lady Vols up nine. Kara Lawson nails the three. Tennessee goes on to win this one. 66-59, the final. 29th straight SEC home win for Tennessee. LaToya Thomas finished with just 16 points. She had just one at the half. Again, waiting for an update on Tamika Catchings. Pat Summitt talks to our Nancy Lieberman-Klein about the game and her star.
What did you tell the players at halftime in the locker room? It was 42-all.
Well, obviously, we're very disappointed with our first half defensive intensity, or lack of, and I thought we were rushing offensively. I thought we got a lot of good looks and just didn't knock down open shots, tried to get Tamika to settle down a little bit on the inside. And they were doubling on our post, so we had to either take the shot or reverse the basketball.
Well, I thought the second half defensively you came out more tenacity. They out-rebounded you in the first half, which was a surprise.
Well, they do a great job of controlling tempo, and obviously they know where their shots are coming from. They do a good job out of, covering the rebound situation. But I thought our team played with a little bit more intensity, got out in passing lanes and did a better job with their ball pressure.
I want to ask you about the status of Tamika Catchings' knee injury.
Well, I don't know, Nance. I mean, my heart sank when I saw her go down, but I did not see her knee buckle. I saw her land. Obviously, she was coming in transition, made the jump stop and hit it hard, but I didn't see her buckle. She said she didn't feel anything inside, but obviously our doctors are looking at her right now. We'll know something soon, and I just hope for Tamika, certainly for her, first and foremost, she's okay.
This season in the NBA, of course, the West has been better than the East by a wide margin. 53 games so far. The one Eastern team doing pretty well, the New York Knicks. 9-5 against the West. Beat the Portland Trail Blazers badly on Saturday night. Knox stopping their 10-game winning streak, and now battling the San Antonio Spurs this afternoon. Latrell Sprewell the bucket, putting the Knicks up seven. Later in the second quarter, Sprewell the steal, pushes it up. And now the turnaround, four-footer. Knicks up by nine at this point. Still second quarter. Kurt Thomas throwing the lob pass. Marcus Camby, the Thunder dunk. Knicks go up by 11 in this one. They lead at the half by 15. They now lead by 21. Middle of the fourth quarter. Spurs had won 10 of their last 13. Of course, the Knicks have held 30 straight opponents under 100 points. Bucks have won nine straight at home, but they've lost their last three or four on the road. They're in D.C. today. Nice move there by Juwan Howard, cutting the Bucks lead to four. Bucks up five, Lindsey Hunter to Jason Caffey. Spin move, slam. Bucks go up by 7, 44-37. Still second quarter. Milwaukee looking to add to their lead. The big dog leading Ray Allen. Poop and the harm. Completes the three-point play. Milwaukee led this one by 8 at the half. It is now 84-70, the Bucks. They are 18-6 after a 3-9 start. The Wizards have lost their last 6. Richard Hamilton with 14 points at the half for the Wizards. The Hornets trail the 70, or now lead the 76ers, 38-34, middle of the second. Hawks on top of the Nets, 15-10 early there. Nets have lost 12 of their last 14. To the ice, Mario back home to host the Mighty Ducks. 9 goals, 10 assists in his first 8 games, early first period. The Mighty Ducks are going to make the move here. Tony Perkis will be loose in front of the net. Bang! Perkis, his 8th of the year from Solani and Marty McInnes. Mighty Ducks lead this one 1-0 at the first intermission. They are winless in their last 4. Of course, the Penguins 5-3 under Lemieux. Tonight on ESPN2, Dallas Stars trying to beat the Florida Panthers for the 5th straight time and win their 5th straight on the road. ESPN2, the place to be, even in South Florida, tonight at 7 Eastern.
This halftime report is presented by Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand for the treatment of yeast infections.
When you have an ailment, different doctors might recommend different treatments. But for women suffering with yeast infections, the number one recommendation of doctors is specific. Monistat. Monistat starts working immediately to relieve the awful burning and itching. And it provides an effective cure. Sure, doctors have many brands of yeast infection medicine to choose from, but Monistat is their number one choice. Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand.
Some people you could always count on to be there for you. We were there when you fixed up your first car. And when you fixed up your first apartment. We were even there when you finally got fixed up yourself. So now that you're fixing more bottles than old cars, there's no one better to talk to about your changing life insurance needs than the State Farm agent you've always trusted to care for your car, your home, and you. State Farm is there for you because State Farm is there for life.
Where's my magazine?
Hey, Ray, can you believe that they got Marcus Camby to do the commercial with the ESPN, the magazine, and not me and you?
I don't know, Chris, but... No, Marcus was pretty good. But we've been perfect for this part.
I know, especially we both subscribers to ESPN the magazine. We both got the free fleece jacket.
When you eat, live, and breathe sports, ESPN the magazine is where you want to be.
You know, Chris, we need to work on this paddle yo-yo thing. I think that's what ESPN the magazine wants.
Yeah, you're probably right, Ray.
We cover every corner of sports, from the legends to the laughs, with previews, predictions, and inside information you can only get from ESPN. All with your favorite ESPN personalities, and all with ESPN attitude.
Okay, we need to rehearse this. Check it. How's this? Where's my magazine?
I like that. What do you think about this stuff? Where's my magazine?
Sorry, that's pretty good, but just be a little bit more emotional. Like, where's my ESPN the magazine?
You are a great actor.
Thanks.
Get 26 issues, a year's worth for just $1 an issue. 66% off the newsstand price. And you'll get our fleece pullover free.
Hey, that's my magazine, man.
Perfect.
Call now for ESPN the magazine and your free fleece. 1-800-634-1325.
Welcome back to SportsCenter In-Game, the Monistat Halftime Report. Notre Dame's Fighting Irish leading UConn by a 40-31 count at the half. In South Bend, we're going to send you out for second half action in just a moment. But first, let's tell you more about Big Monday on ESPN. The only other unbeaten left on the men's side besides number one Stanford, Georgetown. 15-0 record, they take to Seton Hall at 7 Eastern, followed by 15th-ranked UConn's men trying to get back on track in Austin against the Longhorn team. Cranky after losing at Nebraska on Saturday, then after SportsCenter at midnight Eastern a Mountain West battle of, well, different educational philosophies, UNLV and BYU. Some news and notes from around the world of sports. Rick Pitino has told the Boston Globe he will not visit UNLV to check out a possible job offer until after the season. Minnesota's Glenn Mason, Youngstown State's Jim Tressel still believed to be at the top of Ohio State's football coaching wish list. Both Heisman winner Chris Winkie and runner-up Josh Heupel skipping the Senior Bowl, saying they need to rest. Jesse Palmer and Rashard Casey will replace them. The number one defense in the entire NFL has the Baltimore Ravens installed as an early two-point favorite over the New York Giants in the Super Bowl 35. Much more on the Ray Carruth closing arguments tonight at 6 Eastern on SportsCenter. Trey Wingo and Chris McKendry will have it. Again, that's at 6 Eastern on ESPN. This has been the Monistat Halftime Report. Notre Dame by 9 over number one UConn.
Oh, what's that? They're motorized rocket tops. Rocket tops are the first supercharged electro-powered tops of their kind. These are the only tops that have a motorized launcher. So for the first time ever, now you can have supercharged rocket tops. Only rocket tops can do all these amazing tricks in all these amazing colors. They even come with this brand new in-flight booster. So now you can keep your tops cruising for hours. Plus, check this out. The big one even lights up in the dark. You get all 5 rocket tops, the motorized launcher, and the in-flight booster, rocket tops. The complete 7-piece set for $14.95. And you get huge savings on extra sets. Remember, only rocket tops come with the motorized launcher. Rocket tops! Here's how to order.
Rocket tops are $14.95 plus $5.95 shipping and handling. Call or order on the web at 800-586-2310. That's 800-586-2310. You must be 18 or older to call.
When you have an ailment, different doctors might recommend different treatments. But for women suffering with yeast infections, the number one recommendation of doctors is specific. Monistat. Monistat starts working immediately to relieve the awful burning and itching, and it provides an effective cure. Sure, doctors have many brands of yeast infection medicine to choose from, but Monistat is their number one choice. Monistat. The number one doctor-recommended brand.
You are unique, unlike anyone else who's ever drawn breath. But how can you know where you truly belong? Which job opportunity is best for you? It's easy. Go to Randstad. We learn what you want, then represent and market you to find the job that's right for you at no cost. Full-time, part-time, anytime. Find where you belong with Randstad. A brighter way to a better job.
Moments away from the start of the second half, the Irish lead 40-31. Doris Burke with an outstanding first half for the Fighting Irish as we bring you the Nike first half stats.
Well, obviously the field goal percentages. Connecticut comes in shooting 50%. They are at 36. And look at the proficiency from three-point territory. 5 of 7 for Notre Dame.
UConn with possession of the basketball. What do the Notre Dame Fighting Irish need to do? Because you know the Huskies are going to come out on fire, or at least try to be.
Well, they were ice cold in the first half. Continue with a missed shot here, but they're a team that will spurt you, so you must withstand their runs.
Damon, the dump to Rattai. Rattai, loose ball. And Abrosimova saves it again, and right to Schumacher. When you're that good, things like that happen.
And one of the things that Gino talked about at practice and has preached all year to his guys is the fact that, hey, it's not one or two passes and we must score. You've got to run our stuff through. And Notre Dame's making them do that. They quick shot it a lot in that first half. We'll see if they're more efficient here in the second.
Another thing to keep an eye on, Bird rattles in a three. Riley Rattai Ivy played all 20 minutes in the first half.
Muffet joked about it this past week on the conference call. She said, hey, they've got to play 40. There's no two ways about it.
And a foul on Haney.
And that gives Anika choice right off the bench.
That is number 3 on Haney.
assist player than a scorer. She's come out a little bit more aggressive, but Ivy must score, and she did. Quality first half.
Joyce, the freshman in, had 5 points, was productive in the first half, the only member of the Irish to come off the bench.
And have you heard of her? She made some questionable decisions, so Muffet gets her right out of the game.
And a whistle and a foul called.
That's what you can't do. You can't hang your head when you make mistakes. There's a play late in that first half where she missed a chippy. She goes and gets her own board. She puts it back. That's the mentality she must come with.
Just 1 of 8 from the floor. 2 points, 3 rebounds. And Kevin McGough in his 5th year, assistant coach to Muffet McGraw, heads over there and has a quick talk. Joyce, the miss. Bird. Nice move, and a charge. Great D. She made a strong move, and then with Ty and Seaman stepped up.
Bird's mentality has changed. He's saying, pull up and jump shoot it. And that would have been the wise decision. Instead, she takes it right into the help defense. Right there, pull and shoot. Instead, go all the way. You got help defenders, body sprawl.
Ivy. Now, brush him over. Another steal. 2 out. Ralph misses the layup, has missed 2 shots here in the first half, and a foul on the floor. In the first half, Shea Ralph struggled, just 2 points, 1 rebound, and a couple of assists.
And you love the way that Swin Cash runs the floor, and boy, does she get off her feet in a hurry.
Seaman picks up her 2nd. Ivy has 2, Haney on the bench has 3, and the threes are raining in.
Players who steps up at big moments.
A lot of people talking about her back troubles, the back spasm. She says, hey, I'm 100%. Coaching staff says it's 100%. And she has 15 points, but Riley responds.
Well, Riley is poised and patient. 12 points, 6 boards, 4 assists for her.
And Big East play averaging better than 20 points a game and snares that board, takes it away from Schumacher. Out on the wing, here's Joyce for 3. Had one earlier, gets another here.
Yeah, and there's a substitution you got to make with your Muffet. Joyce gave you great minutes. She was poised. She hit shots. So you go with her. How about the assist from Ivy? That's called setting her up.
Playing in only her 6th game this season, and it's a big one and having a big impact.
How about the challenge? Wow.
Lead pass picked off. You notice the 3 that were back that time? The 3 that played 20 minutes in the first half.
They've got a clean spot to get a quick blow. It's not going to be except on timeouts. They're not getting any other time.
Bird. Good help D again.
No, they're really collapsing in that 2-3 zone. Their baseline defense has been outstanding.
They have cut it off all day long. First ever shout-out for a women's basketball game here at the Joyce Center, and they're seeing a great one.
Joyce, a top 30 recruit, someone they were really counting on prior to the injury.
Third, a wild shot, Cash.
Wow, that's very uncharacteristic for her to make a similar kind of mistake.
3-10 now from the floor.
One of the things to think about Sue Bird is her decision-making ability. She's always been so solid. She got caught in the charge. Could have almost gotten caught on one there. Swin Cash bails her out.
Ivy. Under 10 on the shot clock. Good find. Riley misses. Ivy gets it back, and Abrosimova on the reach-in.
You see the difference, though. Notre Dame is willing to work that clock. They're willing to run their sets all the way through. They did not get a particularly good look, but the hustle from Ivy creates a 2nd shot. There's the block attempt. Looks like a lot of ball, but nonetheless, free throws coming.
That is number 1 on spec. Neil Ivy in her 5th year, 2 torn ACLs back in 96, 5 games into the season. And then in 1999, toured in the semifinals against Rutgers of the Big East Championship. And that hurt the Irish. They were dropped to number 5 seed. Neil Ivey racks it up from the free throw line. And the Notre Dame Fighting Irish hold the advantage here at a sold-out Joyce Center.
ESPN and ESPN2, home of the Women's NCAA Championship.
Don't even think about it. Why do we always have to...
.com Hula Bowl, Saturday at 8 on ESPN.
Notre Dame with the lead, 47-39. Home of the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship. ESPN and ESPN2, and two teams that are expected to be there in St. Louis. And take a look at the bench. Has it been a factor? You take a look at the season, and of course, they have been prior to this afternoon's game.
Now you're talking about 35 points per game, but today, 10. What a difference. He said the bench might not be that much of a factor if Notre Dame could play at the pace they want. And they've picked their spots to run. They've stuck in that 2-3 zone. They've taken away Connecticut's transition game. They're challenging their outside jump shooting. That's how you beat Connecticut. You know, you take your chances, but make them beat you from the perimeter.
The only common opponent is Georgia. And when I called him up, he said, these teams are like night and day. They may be two totally different things.
But you've got a team in Notre Dame who fulfills roles. Ivy, the consummate point guard, can score. Riley, the true center.
Riley, the rejection. How about this? Riley at the defensive end, offensive end. Here she is. 5 minutes into the second half, does not have a foul.
And yet she's been aggressive with the block shot attempts. You like that mentality. Now she wants it, you got to get it to her.
Seaman. For three. We're tied from the outside.
They're a balanced club. If you elect to double Ruth, you're going to pay somewhere else. Your tie benefited.
Aprosimova answers. 18 points.
Yeah, she is single-handedly keeping this bargain.
18 of the 42. Notre Dame, 7 of 10 from beyond the arc, but getting all that work down low on the inside early on has opened up the outside.
Yeah, no question. You establish in, then you go out.
The step through, and a foul. That's Aprosimova's second.
Fouls on the Huskies, number 25, Svetlana Aprosimova, her second.
One of the things I talked to Shea about before the game, I asked her, I said, how important is it that your opponent come in with a mentality that they can compete? She said, I'll tell you the truth. She said, the bottom line is we sense it when somebody doesn't believe that they can compete. She says, as a freshman, when we used to face Tennessee, there was that little bit of doubt in the corner of our minds. It wasn't until we beat them that we got that sense that, yes, we are among the best in the country. She makes a great point, and I think she's got to know there's a difference in Notre Dame today.
No question about that. And Muffet McGraw, Doris, had the opportunity to speak to Digger Phelps last week, knows something or two about beating number ones that are on a streak, and he had some great advice for her.
Well, he told her, if you believe in your game plan, stick to it. You can't be afraid to take risks. You've got to go with what's working for you, and her game plan has been perfect. She's got an outstanding staff over with her. Carol Owens, Kevin McGuff, they are quality assistants who have been with her consistently.
Carol Owens has done a great job with Ruth Riley. Turnaround shot, Jones doesn't go. Lead pass. Seaman comes away with it, has been deflected. And how about her game? Into double figures with 11, has 6 rebounds and a broken left hand.
Wow, good shot by Svetter. Nice job to get along that baseline side. What a difference Seaman has made today. She said to her teammate after the Virginia Tech loss, she said, look, it's broken, but I'm playing. And if it takes a broken hand and me adjusting to that for us to win, then so be it.
A foul against UConn.
Number 3, Diana Taurasi, her second.
You see the hand there, the left hand, heavily wrapped. with the glove on the outside of it, protecting it with the pad.
You like her mentality here. She could have elected to dribble out and set the offense, but just one defender on her, so she elects to go two.
They'll X-ray it again tomorrow. And we'll see if she'll miss any time after this game. Mm. But she's not missing any time right now.
That's what Coakley's wife said. She said, we'll give her rest time after today.
For Notre Dame, it's all about today. Crashing the boards, Jones. Bird. That's what Gino was talking about, but it didn't go down. The putback's good.
Yeah, they're relentless on the glass. You've got Williams and Cash, two quality jumpers right now. Now you wonder if fatigue will start to affect this team. Will the depth of Connecticut wear you down eventually?
Six-point game. Tamika Williams. Her game off of the bench has been outstanding this season. Svetlana. Any concerns about her back or any doubts about it? Well, guess what? 7 of 14 from the floor. And another foul on Taurasi. That is her third.
That was an issue for Coach Oriana during break. Svetlana goes with Shea Ralph. They play in a pickup game. She hurts her back. Suffered through some back spasms, but she's fluid right now.
She had struggled with her shot, but her other parts of the game are still there. Rebounding, steals. Riley looking for Seaman. And if Rosamova is going to be charged with a foul, that's three, so that's a concern. She's got three.
All you want to do if you're the weak side, Kelly Seaman, is get yourself in front of your defender. And she's done a magnificent job of doing that. She's reading the double team. This is a two-man job. Ruth's got to feel it, then she's got to pass it. And Seaman steps in front of Svetlana, forces her to commit that third.
All her fouls this half. For Seaman, that is huge. You can see Seaman. The body language as she puts up the shot, because she's only a 45% free throw shooter.
Anything to get it in there. Lean, talk to it, whatever you have to do.
It works that time, 3 of 6 from the free throw line. 13 points for Seaman, averaging 10 on the season. Riley gets a hand of it, lead pass, Seaman.
Wow.
Big time bucket for Kelly Seaman. 15 points, a Notre Dame game high. Abrosimova has 20 for the Huskies. Tapped out, they're getting to every loose ball. Limiting second chance opportunities. Haney trying to get established.
Surprised Gino not using a timeout, but I think he wants to get a sense of where his team is at.
58-46. Their largest lead in the first half, 13. And a foul on Seaman.
He has sat in that position. Now, normally, most coaches at this point in the game would have already used a timeout. Notre Dame responded to your initial run. They go on a run of your own. They've got the momentum. But he's going to try to let his guys figure it out.
There's always a method to what he does. And he has done an outstanding job in his tenure.
Well, we were worried about fatigue. How about Seaman, the ability to get herself squared, knowing where she is on the floor? Made it look easy. That was a tough shot.
That's huge. Wow. Because you turned that around. That's UConn's game.
Yes.
That's not Notre Dame's game. A timeout on the floor. And the Irish lead. Enjoying it. Undefeated.
It's time for the Infinite Travel Answer Dance Contest. We've got two teams. Team number one is Meredith Curley and Dean Johnson against team number two.
You are a lioness. Very sexy, very sensual. Make love to the camera. Yes!
Want a better way to save money?
New camera, please.
You can save big bucks by dialing 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
What it is, what it feels like, what it is, what it feels like, what it is. We know what social anxiety can feel like.
And Paxil can help. Over 10 million people suffer from overwhelming anxiety that significantly impairs work or social life, and a chemical imbalance could be to blame. Paxil, the only medication proven effective for social anxiety disorder, works to correct this imbalance. Paxil is not for everyone. Tell your doctor what medicines you're taking. People taking MAOI should not take Paxil. Paxil side effects may include decreased appetite, dry mouth, sweating, nausea, constipation, sexual side effects in men and women, yawn, tremor, or sleepiness. With time, your doctor's help, and Paxil, life can feel like life again. Paxil, your life is waiting.
What'd you get for 26? See? 68 and 74.
CNC. Pencils down.
Right down the center. Not so great for taking tests, but great for collect calls. You can save big bucks by dialing 1-800-CALL-ATT.
Notre Dame by 11, 11:15 remaining in the second half. There's more basketball tonight on ESPN with some top-ranked matchups. Big Monday kicks off at 7 o'clock Eastern when number 11 Georgetown meets number 19 Seton Hall. Then the number 15th-ranked UConn Huskies visit the Texas Longhorns in Austin, Texas, following SportsCenter. It's a Mountain West battle when UNLV plays the BYU Cougars. Watch Big Monday tonight starting at 7 o'clock Eastern. For more, log on to ESPN.com.
Craig Escherich doing the job at Georgetown. And I feel like the mid-80s are starting to come back. He's got a freshman by the name of Mike Sweetney playing some basketball.
Max Good doing the job at UNLV right now. Rick Ty, another three. Pops in and out. Haney. Riley. She'll head to the line. 14 points, Ruth Riley.
Second chance shots. Muffet McGraw puts Haney back in. She gave her some time to collect herself on the bench. Haney off the miss gets him a second look. Riley benefits as a result. And I thought it was a quick look. They had a new shot clock. They could have used some time. Instead, they get a three-point play.
Muffet McGraw said, as you see the concern, Gino Auriemma, that no question, UConn's the best team in the nation, and it's nice now to come into a game as an underdog.
Yes. She's been heavily favored. Look at the range. Wow.
Doesn't go. The board and the putback. Williams. 9 points. Riley picks up the foul. That's her first.
One of the things to think about with Connecticut is the front line and the junior class of Cash, Williams, and Jones, so tough on the glass, and they're going to compete and compete, and eventually they're going to get production up there.
Williams, 67%. 11-point game again. Pressure on the inbounds. Johnson off of the bench for the Huskies. Goes for the steal, and Ivy able to handle it. Seaman puts it on the floor with the left hand. Another second chance opportunity, and Riley is taken down by Johnson.
Well, you see that Connecticut at this point looking to extend pressure, trying to make some things happen defensively. Gino knows they need turnovers, so he tries to create some. The pressure there, you've got to get beyond that. Ivy does a good job of getting by. She allows Seaman to look, but the aggressiveness of Ruth Riley to go after it. Kenitra Johnson makes sure she doesn't have an opportunity for a three-point play.
Riley, 76% three-throw shooter, 4-4 on the day. Rosamova Jones out. Cash and Bird back on the court for UConn.
Here's an area where Ruth has really improved. You have to work with your center who gets to the free-throw line so often. 69% as a sophomore. She was 80% last year. She's been sensational.
Has 17 points over her last six games, averaging better than 21 points a game. Johnson for three. It pops in and out. Seaman, another rebound.
Yeah, Notre Dame's pursuit of the basketball on both ends has been outstanding. They're just beating Connecticut to the ball, and you wouldn't think they could, because really, the better athleticism in the front court lies with Connecticut.
Riley. Nice move. She caught that ball deep.
Now, you got to use some time out here. I understand you want to see where your team's at, but use one.
Down 15. Their largest lead, Bird. Doesn't respond. And it's Notre Dame basketball.
Maybe he thinks that if they're not self motivated to play the number three team in the country. Somebody who's desperate to beat him, then there's nothing he can say to get him motivated. It's the only thing I can think that he's thinking.
That is a rarity. UConn has never led. And one of the things he talked about prior to the start of the game, he said, I know they're going to pack down in that zone. And he said, I know that we have to make threes. It's like going in to take on a team like Temple. If you make threes, then, hey, you got a chance. If you don't, then you don't have a chance. And right now, shooting just 30%, 7 of 23 from three-point range. And because they haven't been able to hit it from the outside, it's doing nothing for them on the inside.
Yeah, well, I think Notre Dame's baseline defense all afternoon has been extremely solid. And if there is something that you want to test for Connecticut, is you see the free throw differential, and that's because they're setting the tone, Notre Dame. They're getting the free throw line because they're the aggressors right now.
17-point game. And a turnover.
Yeah, nice job by Bonita Spence. She makes contact with Patty Broderick. The whistle blows, but they make eye contact, and then they make their decision as to who that ball went off of.
UConn not handling this right now.
Mm-mm. Nope.
And another foul. That's number four. From the floor, 0-4 from three-point range has not been a factor, and she usually is.
She is one of the outstanding freshmen in the country. She's had a tough afternoon, but can flat-out play this young lady. Can shoot it, can pass it.
For the Huskies, number 44.
But she, today, trying to make some things happen. Obvious contact. You never admit it.
Returning for the Huskies, number 15, Asia Jones.
Jones in. That bench has not been a factor. They have not provided that second burst or even a first burst because their starters didn't.
One of the things that Stamp talks about is the fact that their players need to know that they're in control. Well, right now it's Notre Dame who's in control of this ballgame.
Christine Rigby checks in. And there's a three.
Taurasi.
One of six from the floor. That ended a 16-4 run by the Irish.
Stay patient here.
Foul on Jones.
Connecticut right now being forced to make things happen. So if you're patient and you're strong with the basketball, you're either going to get by it or you're going to get to the free throw line.
So Seaman heads to the line. 3 of 6 from the free throw line. Misses the first. Mentioned it earlier, but check this out. Today's attendance, the largest ever for a Notre Dame women's team. Better than 11,000, and they came here early. They were sold out at 9:30 this morning on a snowy, cold day in South Bend, Indiana when we came in this morning. Saw a couple of people lined up outside with blankets and hot coffee and chocolate.
And they were on it.
I tell you what, they weren't able to get tickets. They were shut out. They've been talking about this for a long time.
Folks, she's big time. She is trying her best to get her club back in it.
Has hit two consecutive threes. We're here at the Joyce Center in South Bend, Indiana. Matt Devlin along with Doris Burke. Number one ranked UConn Huskies against a number two, or rather three ranked Notre Dame Fighting Irish. These two teams, the only unbeatens in the land right now.
Another opportunity here because of a consistent theme. Riley doubles, Seaman steps two. There was an adjustment there by Connecticut. They just didn't do it in time.
So after making two big buckets,
Taurasi picks up number five.
She had the right idea. She was trying to take a charge on play that she anticipated. She just didn't beat Seaman to the spot.
7:24 remains. 68-56. And Seaman, Ratai, Riley. Can they hold it together for another 7 minutes and 24 seconds?
Yeah, this is reminiscent of Muffet's breakthrough year. The similarities for 97 this year's Notre Dame team, senior leadership. You got five quality seniors, five quality people.
Disgusted with the performance this afternoon. There's Seaman at the free throw line. Courageous afternoon for her.
Missed her last three.
Misses both. That could be a factor.
Second consecutive time they give up an offensive board to Riley. I mean, that's inexcusable.
7:15 remains. Riley guarded by Rigby.
Oh, nice step through. Very pretty. Her stock going up right now because she's proven she can get up and down the floor.
21 points and 12 rebounds. Another double-double, and she has never had this sort of game against the Huskies. Bird stops and pops.
And Johnson and Ivy, they are hitting each other, and the official Patty Broderick got to get on this. Ivy's frustrated. Johnson is really hitting her.
Johnson took down Riley earlier. Entry pass. And a foul's going to be called on Rigby.
Well, you know what Gino is thinking here. He's matching body for body with Rigby. But the big word in college basketball is displacement. The defensive player cannot displace the offensive player on the post.
Rigby 6'6". Riley 6'5". And Riley heads to the free throw line. A perfect 5 of 5. 22 points now for Ruth Riley.
You make your decision against Connecticut. I mean, against Notre Dame. You decide you want to double Ruth and give up perimeter jump shots? Or do that weak side cut that Seaman's been so effective at? Or do you challenge for time?
Ruth Riley, 23 points, 12 rebounds. It's been all Notre Dame. 72-58, 6:23 to play. Don't go anywhere. It's a great one.
Hi, I'm Mike McCrary, number 99 of the Ravens, for Baltimore's other superstar, Musselman's Dodge.
Musselman's Dodge Used Car Superstore has the finest selection of used cars anywhere, including caravans, SUVs, and 4x4s, and all at super low prices.
Now that's a winning deal.
Plus, all come with a minimum 3-month, 3,000-mile service contract, personalized service, and helpful financing.
I ask you again, how can you lose? You can't.
Musselman's Dodge Used Car Superstore, Route 40 West, just off Beltway Exit 15A.
The superstar of used cars.
The law is written by and for lawyers. Any legal process can be lengthy and confusing. It can be difficult to protect your rights or even know what they are without the aid of an attorney. At Goldman, Skeen & Wadley, we demystify the legal process and guide our clients through a traumatic period, whether it's an auto injury, accident at work, divorce, or medical malpractice, so you can focus on recovery. Any lawyer can practice law. Call Goldman, Skeen & Wadley for compassionate and clear representation. 410-837-4222.
When you have an ailment, different doctors might recommend different treatments. But for women suffering with yeast infections, the number one recommendation of doctors is specific. Monistat. Monistat starts working immediately to relieve the awful burning and itching, and it provides an effective cure. Sure, doctors have many brands of yeast infection medicine to choose from, but Monistat is their number one choice. Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand.
Ruth Riley proving that she is the most dominant center in the game.
Well, she's been effective either for herself or getting others involved, imposing her will on that baseline. Just a pretty step-through move here. You actually get decent position. You force her away from the bucket a little bit. But how about the spin, the step two to get around Rigby? Texas UConn career coming into today's game, only 11 points, 7 boards, 53%. Not bad numbers, but look at today's effort.
Has been a factor and a force. She is the best center in the land, and she has been outstanding. And how about 4 assists? But I think the key, one foul.
Her pursuit of the basketball, one foul just by being aggressive, trying to block shots.
Bird with the basketball. Rigby wants it. Abrosimova sends it to her. Feeds it back. 5 on the shot clock. And a travel prior.
Well, they got better patience. They didn't get any better result. And Muffet's team is doing a great job defensively, recovering, sucking down, then sucking back out to shooters.
Riley decides to handle it. And a whistle and a foul. Right now, Notre Dame dealing. And just a time where they are the ones that are going to secure things here and take care of the basketball. 5:49 remaining. 72-58. Abrosimova picks up the foul. That's number 4. And she has been the only offensive force for them. And Shea Ralph on the afternoon, just 1 of 4. 2 points. And she has been on that bench for a long time.
And look at this. Another offensive board off another missed free throw. They're flat out beating them with the basketball right now.
Bird picks up the foul. That's her third.
At the line for the Irish,
so all of a sudden, that gap, there's some foul troubles in there. And Seaman unable to connect.
Well, they tighten this thing up. I don't think there's any question who they're going to put at the foul line.
3 of 11 on the day.
Yeah, now the question is, will they bother to check out on the shot?
16 of 26 are the Irish. Second doesn't go. 16 of 27 on the day. Long range. And a UConn Husky foul. Against Jones.
15, Asia Jones.
Muffet McGraw, in talking to her, as Jones picks up number 4, felt that coming out that her team would be a little bit nervous and that she would actually have to sustain and respond to the UConn Huskies. But that has not been the case. It was the other way around. The tone was set by McGraw's team.
But the last 4 years, they're 106-26 coming into the season. Now, they haven't lost. You got to get some measure of confidence from all that success. Both her as a coach, confidence-wise, and her team.
Let me pose this question to you. UConn's number 1. Tennessee is number 2. Notre Dame is unbeaten. There's still time, 5:25 remaining, 75-58. Who's number 1?
Well, I think one of the things the pollsters are going to look at is the catching's gone. Then obviously Notre Dame goes number 2 immediately. I think if she is okay and there's a response, that she'll come back, because I believe Tennessee is the next most talented team in the country.
So they would move to number 1, and Notre Dame wouldn't hop over it. You're not a college hoops fan unless you have ESPN Full Court, ESPN's college basketball pay-per-view package. You'll see over 450 college hoop games of your favorite teams and conferences, no matter where you live. To order Full Court, call your cable company, DirecTV, at 1-800-DIRECTV or Dish Network at 1-800-333-DISH. If they win, the Notre Dame Fighting Irish today against UConn, they need to leap right over Tennessee.
They should.
They should, no question about it. But there's still
Tennessee
time.
Tennessee was unable to beat them. And remember, Tennessee went down 17 before scrapping to get back into that game.
Can UConn scrap to get back in this one? Notre Dame's making it tough. Under 5 minutes remaining.
Haney shows the ball and goes. How about that?
How about her mental toughness? Yes, you deserve it. Because you had a tough first half.
No doubt about that. Now with 8 points. Jones gets by Riley, and then Riley commits the foul. And
fouls on the Irish, double zero, Ruth Riley, her third.
It's 77-59. Riley just picked up her third. Take a look at the ESPN USA Today coaches poll, top 25. UConn sits atop. There's Tennessee. Their only loss to UConn, and Notre Dame 16-0.
Well, Georgia, a team that has lost to both Notre Dame and Connecticut. And the last unbeaten. How about Kim Mulkey Robertson's job at Baylor? Started the season 13-0.
Has done an outstanding job down in Waco. So Riley has three now. That could be a factor. Retire. Seaman. Do not count it. Look at Muffet's response, waving her arm, saying, come on, give it to me.
This is not the WNBA. She's had a lot go right. Not normally a dribble driver. The contact well before the shot. Next year, if Miss Seaman is fortunate enough to play in the next level.
Well, you know what? With the way Seaman has been shooting from the free throw line, she gets down low like that. Put her there.
No question.
Because she has not been able to hit it all day long. And
she's leaving the foul line before she even completes her motion. But you've got to stick there on the free throw line. That's bad form.
3 of 14. Haney gets bumped out of bounds by Bird. And Bird picks up number 4. 4:13 remaining.
Number 10, Sue Bird.
Situation.
Remember when ESPN carried the opener and it was Georgia, Connecticut. Connecticut destroyed an Andy Landers team that is always tough-minded. You should see the team foul comparison. What a difference. People were around the country were saying, geez, can anyone beat Connecticut? Then they go up 17 on Tennessee. Well, how about Notre Dame? The toughness of mind to be 0-11 against Gino Auriemma and his Huskies and come in here and have this kind of effort.
A lot of talk about greatness with the UConn Huskies, but you talk to their coaching staff, and you know what? They know that that talk should not be bannered about. It's too early.
Well, this will certainly allow Gino to get their attention back if he had ever lost it, which I doubt.
Syracuse, they struggled at Syracuse last week, and then they responded against Providence College, scoring over 100. And Bird gets the bucket. Providence College, they needed you back on the court.
That might have hurt them some more.
No way, you kidding me? And a whistle and a foul. It is on Ivy.
Fouls on the Irish, number 33.
Well, Muffet McGraw said Neil Ivy is the best point guard in the land, and there's some differing opinions on that, but no doubt about it, the emotional leader and a stabilizer today and hit big threes.
I think there's certainly a lot of candidates out there for point guard. You got to look at Kelly Miller of Georgia.
Bird not in time. It's Notre Dame's basketball with 3:39 to go. Can Notre Dame hold on? Up 78-64. They want to see it here at the Joyce Center. The number one ranked Huskies right now having big time problems with Notre Dame 78-64.
You're talking about the number one team in the land who averages 92 points per game. Buffett said it. She changed her mentality as a coach. She used to think, I'm going to flat out outscore you, outshoot you, outrun you, do what I need to do. But defensively, the mindset is different, and I think her kid's feeding off of that.
Ivy calls a timeout.
I think the pressure. You're gonna face it. You knew that coming in. So you here's 72% of her games, five straight NCAA appearances, the breakthrough in 97 to the Final Four.
And of course, you can tie St. Joe's to a lot of great coaches, going all the way back to Dr. Jack Ramsey. And the current Boston Celtic head coach and Jim O'Brien. Joyce turns it over with three in her face. Here's Bird looking for three. Got it.
Now this one not over. They got 3:15 and 11 points, a three-point arc. How much does it change college basketball?
No question about it. UConn calls a timeout. And one of the concerns, the ability of having somebody else handle that pressure outside of Neil Ivey, and you can see it there.
Neil Ivey has got to be the one that you get the basketball to. And Muffet McGraw, as you said, thinks she's the best point guard in the country. Let's hear some of her thoughts.
Well, when she got hurt her freshman year, we thought, you know, I know things happen for a reason. What possible reason could there be? And then when we saw the Final Four was in St. Louis, I thought maybe God wants to send her home for the Final Four. And, boy, she's somebody that deserves it. Our whole team really relies on her for so much leadership, so much emotion and passion, and the respect they have for her for what she's been through.
Ivy said that she appreciates the ability to play. Being on the court means something to her. The 1996 Missouri Player of the Year said she receives phone calls constantly throughout the course of every week. Hey, can't wait to see you in St. Louis. She said, wait a minute, we got to get there first, and certainly making their case on a day like today.
I think she swing cash hit Seaman. Why not? You got to manage the clock if Seaman is really struggling at the foul line.
It's exactly the case.
Left the free throw line before she's gotten through her motion. Not that time, but just uncomfortable. Now, you don't see in this day and age a lot of women leave their feet on free throws, but she does.
You see on the season, well, she would settle for what she has done on the season with her effort on the foul line.
Doesn't
go.
That jump shot for free throw is tough.
But without her, they wouldn't be in the situation that...
That's a double dribble. Yes, ma'am, Patty Broderick.
Patty Broderick has a call and another turnover by the Huskies and Notre Dame.
Well, she's trying to make the pass opposite. That she doesn't quite get there.
Seaman takes a seat. Haney and Joyce on the floor, along with Ivy, Rattai and Riley. So Seaman gets a rare break, but that's because of her free throws. And a foul.
Asia Jones trying to defend Ruth Riley. Ruth had excellent position. Asia a little bit too physical.
Number 15, Asia Jones.
Asia Jones picks up the foul. And that is number 5 on Asia Jones to join Taurasi on the bench. Both have fouled out.
Notre Dame has set the tone of this ball game by being aggressive inside, both defensively and offensively.
The foul's 27 to 12. 9 points for Asia on the season, averaging 9.8. 78-67. Notre Dame has won 31 in a row here at home. And for the Huskies, it has been a while. 30 consecutive games, the longest streak in the nation.
Yeah, their last loss last February. Remember, it was Samika Randall who virtually dribbled through Connecticut's entire defense, hit a really tough shot. They will face off February 1 in Knoxville on ESPN.
Boo Randall.
Yes.
That nickname goes back a couple of years.
Returning for the Irish,
because of the way she was received by the fans. Riley gets both at a key moment to stretch the lead back out. 80-67, under 2:30 to go here at the Joy Center. Number 1 UConn against number 3 Notre Dame. Bird off balance. And Bird will head to the free throw line. Only 9 trips there on the day. UConn 5 of 9. Ivy picks picks up number four.
This group is. They're down, they know it, but their mentality is always collective, together.
How about Shea Rock? Where has she been in the second half?
Well, she struggled of late.
Haney finds Ivy. Ivy to Haney. Haney goes for the bucket and draws contact instead of pulling it out and working the clock.
Well, that's exactly what Muffet looked at Ivy and said, no, 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 pull it back.
On the Huskies, number 20, Morgan Valley, her first. At the line for the Irish.
Joe Haney heads to the free throw line. On the season, 66%. And it boils down to this. Can they make those shots down the stretch? Seaman back in, so you know when she touches it, the Huskies will be all over it.
Well, she's your best rebounder, and you're going back on the defensive end, so she's got to be in the basketball game.
The Irish have made their last four free throws. 23 of 39 from the free throw line now. UConn just 5 of 11. Misses. Loose ball tapped out of Bosomova. Has been their only offensive force with 20. The dump down low. And a foul's going to be called. And this is key. Because if it's on Riley, it's number four. And if it's on Seaman, it's number four. It is on Riley. So Ivy and Riley.
Yeah, they're trying hard to defend the three-point arc, which means your inside people are forced to check man-to-man.
Can they buy a minute 45? Cash.
Returning for the Irish.
Joyce. Comes in. Nice move by Muffet.
Yeah, she's going offense, defense here. Joyce gives you another ball handler. Haney can handle it if she needs to.
Rattai throws it ahead to Haney. Has Joyce. Joyce, the bucket misses. That could be a key miss. Does UConn take advantage? Cash misses. The putback, count it.
Yeah, Riley wasn't as aggressive. She doesn't want to pick up five, so you can go right at her if you're Connecticut.
Ivy. It's all about managing that clock right now.
Yeah, remember the Georgia game, folks. Senior on ESPN. It was at Thanksgiving time. Georgia made a late press and charge, and there were some moments where Muffet McGraw's club had some silly turnovers. So did they learn from that experience?
The foul on Morgan Valley.
Returning for the Irish, number 50.
Seaman comes in.
How about Rattai? Your 87% free throw shooter misses it.
They had made four consecutive prior to that miss. Needs it here. Wow. Hangs on the lip of the rim and curls in. 83-71. Notre Dame right now over the number one ranked UConn Huskies. Bird with the bucket. And a timeout taken by the Huskies.
You don't need a lot of threes. You can go quick twos if you want, but now you got to come fast quickly because you're working with the minute 13. Ideally three, but quick two if you can get it.
There's more great women's basketball next Sunday on ESPN2 with the Big 12 ACC Challenge. The action starts at 1 o'clock Eastern time when the number 7th ranked Iowa State Cyclones take on the number 18th ranked North Carolina State Wolfpack. Then at 3 o'clock, number 16, Oklahoma meets the North Carolina Tar Heels. See both of these great games next Sunday on ESPN2. ESPN and ESPN2, the exclusive home of the women's NCAA basketball tournament.
How about Iowa State and the job Bill Fennelly has done, taking a program from obscurity and making a legitimate top 10. Angie Welly, an outstanding player. And Stacy Dales at Oklahoma, a quality player.
Bill spent time here.
Yes, under Muffet.
Here is a game story. How about
the field goal percentage there, 38%. And then Seaman, Ivy, and Riley, 56 points and a bundle of minutes.
There's nothing like seniors in college basketball. It's Morgan and Gaither who got Muffet to a first Final Four. It might be that trio who gets it to a second.
Valley commits the foul. Riley, Ivy, Rashai have gone Morgan the entire Valley way for Muffet McGraw, and she said, we needed that.
And the line for
10-point game.
Shooting two, Neal Ivy.
Ruth Riley, what an afternoon. 27 points and 12 rebounds, 11 of 11 from the free throw line.
How big a maturity from a player who couldn't stay on the floor consistently as a freshman to a player, as you said, who had one foul for a large portion of that game, and it's got four now, but played the majority of this game with excellent defense without committing those physical, silly fouls.
Offensive rebound after the miss. That's huge. Haney, a good job. And a foul on Riley, who has been perfect from the charity stripe, heads that way as a team, just 24-43.
Women's college basketball become a little bit more interesting all of a sudden.
No doubt about that. Notre Dame a minute away from upsetting the number one ranked UConn Huskies. Tennessee right now number two in the land. Notre Dame making a strong case to be number one next week. They beat them here. They deserve it. Valley from the outside. Loose ball. Under 45 seconds. Johnson the bucket. Pressure on the inbound.
Just got to inbound it and make free throws.
Rattai. Does that do it?
Goliath has finally hit the deck for Notre Dame.
30 straight games, the longest streak in the nation. 29.3 tenths of a second remaining here at the Joyce Center, 87-76. Notre Dame, the second longest winning streak in the land. They have won 16 straight here this season. Their best ever start. Here on ESPN.
Well, take a giant wave bucket and throw it off your back. You broke through, and a little icing on the cake. Haney, the finish.
Enjoying it right now. And you hear it here at the Joyce Center, the chant of we're number one.
No question about it.
Spectacular job by Muffet McGraw and her team.
And that hand is for Ruth Riley.
Ruth Riley checks out. Ivy checks out. Riley, 29 points, 12 rebounds. Ivy, 14 points, 10 assists. Seconds. And what a day for the Irish. They didn't even need their luck.
No, they did on sheer ability and will.
Notre Dame does it. Notre Dame defeats the mighty UConn Huskies. And their streak has ended. Notre Dame is 17-0 on the season. Their first win ever. They had lost 11 in a row against the UConn Huskies. Sports. For Doris Burke, I'm Matt Devlin, and our entire crew. What a day for the Irish in South Bend, Indiana.